The distortion section of the Varus Ti has had a significant overhaul in OS 3.0, so let's have a look at what we've done. Distortion is located in the FX1 page now, and to activate the parameters, you just need to select a distortion type like this. Now over here, we have a mix control now, and this is available to all the distortion types, both new and old, and allows you to set the balance between the clean signal and the output of the distortion effect. This means you can now apply some really extreme distortion, but still retain the full playability of the patch. Now the new wide distortion is a fantastic all-purpose distortion effect, which benefits from an extremely wide dynamic range of plus 80 decibels. This means that you can set intensity to zero, and the sound will be completely unaffected, like this. And then you can achieve anything from subtle distortion all the way to complete destruction. Another very important feature of the new distortions is the filter section, which allows you first to boost the treble frequencies at the distortion input, and then roll them off again at the output. So you can use treble boost to stimulate the distortion like this. And high cut to make the result less harsh and somewhat more analog sounding. Listen to the mix control now as well in action. So we've kept all of the original Varus distortions to ensure full compatibility with existing presets. And all but the last four in the list, the 1-bit filters and the old bit and rate reducers, will benefit from the filter section as well. But we've also developed a brand new bit reducer and rate reducer, which instead of the filter section, have a quality parameter. This is a unique feature which allows you to control the harshness of the quantization. So let's listen to the bit reducer, the most polite quality setting. As I turn up the quality, you can hear everything just breaks into pieces there. And we've also got a similar control for the rate reducer, although the effect is a little different. The new distortion types also include three new shaper algorithms, sine fold, triangle fold, and sawtooth fold. I'll just show you my personal favourite, sawtooth fold. I like the way this one just falls apart and goes completely wrong around about the clipping threshold there. Just completely brutal sound. Okay, so that's the new distortion section.